house of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you.
Because of who you are, I give you praise. Praise the Lord, saints. I hope you're having a wonderful day thus far. I want to thank you for joining us for tonight's program, Cultivating Spiritual Excellence. Our host is Dr. Marshall, who you'll be hearing from shortly. I'm Brother Marshall, and it's truly an honor that you're joining with us tonight. It isn't by chance that you're listening. God wants to make a difference in your life. He's calling you tonight. Will you answer? Now, before we get into tonight's lesson, let us pray for the minister and the word the Lord is going to bring forth. Hallelujah, Lord. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for this opportunity to lift up your name on high. You're so amazing, Lord. Worship your holy name. I'm praying right now that you consecrate the atmosphere. Lord, I'm praying for Dr. Marshall. I'm praying, Lord, that you will just bless the listeners across the globe as they are present. Right now, Lord, I'm praying that you will minister to their hearts, Lord Jesus. I'm praying that your anointing will move in your servant today. I pray, Lord, that you will remove any hindrances that the enemy has placed before us. I pray that you truly bless us in this place tonight, Lord. You're worthy to be praised, Father God. I magnify your name, in the name of precious, in your precious name, Lord Jesus. Amen. At this time, I'll be turning this portion of the program over to Dr. Marshall.
Lord, glory to God. It's an honor to have you joining us today on Choice Radio. It's your life, your salvation, and your choice. We are truly excited to share the Word of God tonight. Now, let's have a little chat before we get into the message. What I've realized now is this is my observation, that many Christians have strayed from studying God's Word. And we have a goal in mind. We recognize that many Christians need to have personal Bible studies in their home. Years ago, the dad, the head of the home, gathered the wife and the children around the table, kitchen table, and they would have a Bible study at least one night a week. But it seems to be drifting. Now, this program is designed to have believers take up their Bible one more time. The Bible declares in 2 Timothy 2:15 that we should study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not be ashamed to rightly divide the word of truth. There are many arguments and various things about scriptures, but if you study, you would have a handle on it. How do you study God's word? My observation, the modern day Christian use a cell phone or a tablet or a much better computer. But somehow, I don't believe that's a connection. But Paul declares, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. To everyone that believe, to the Jew first and also to the Greek, Romans 1:16. The enemy somehow has fooled Christians. Now they have a spirit of fear. They're not witnessing as they should. They're not studying and applying God's word as they should. And what I realized too, that even pastors and elders and leaders, not even walking with the Bible. I believe you got to identify with Christ. Let's go back to the basic foundation. Let's go back to the roots. The whole thing about the church is a family. God instituted the family. Adam and Eve, in case that was a family. And God ordained it that way so the family would worship. What's going on in the world now? No worship in the home. But we need to get back to basis. We can't tell who are saints now of God. Not even dress code they obeying. But I want to bring you in remembrance. Wherefore, I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God, which is in thee, by putting on of my hands. This is Paul. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me, his prisoner. But be thou partakers of the affliction of the gospel according to the power of God. That's 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 6 to 8. Now, good Bible tools to study God's word. You get a good King James Bible, 1611, because they have a lot of commentaries, which you still have to go back to the original. Get a good Bible dictionary. Get a concordance. Get a good notebook. And start to study to show yourself approved unto God that you are worthy to be called a child of God. Now, we want to speak or look at the subject tonight, a stunning comparison between the ark and the church. A stunning comparison between the ark and the church. Now, I have selected a few scriptures here. We would not read all, but our text basically would be coming from three chapters in Genesis. Genesis chapter 6, Genesis chapter 7, Genesis chapter 8. And with regards to the church, we'll be reading Matthew 24, 35 to 39. Now, it's amazing to think that God, before he destroyed the earth because of sin and rebellion by man, still remembered man and have provided a way of escape to save him. God is a loving God. That's why Christ came, for God so loved the world. It's something about man with regards to God. Man was made to worship, and God, I believe, somehow longed for that worship. Now, it was the ark in the Old Testament, and now it's in the church in the New Testament that secures a place of safety by God. Now let's look at the ark. The name is given to three vessels mentioned in the Bible. We have Noah's ark. This vessel in which Noah and his family were saved during the flood. It was made of gopher wood, which, on account of its lightness and durability, was employed by the Phoenicians for shipbuilding. A covering of pitch was laid inside and outside to make it lightweight. Also within the story with Moses, the ark of the bulrushes in Exodus chapter 2 verse 3, it is recorded that when the mother of Moses could no longer hide him, she placed him among the reeds of the Nile River in an ark or a boat or a basket of bulrushes. It was durable, and in and out was paste with slime and pitch. This ark was made from papyrus reed, which grows in the marshy plains of Egypt. And we also know the ark of the covenant. Was a common chest. It is called the ark of the covenant in Numbers 10 and 33 because in it were deposited the tablets or the stone of the 10 commandments, which were written by the finger of God, God's commandments to Israel. The Ark of the Testament, the commandment being a testimony respecting his own holiness and the place of sin, the Ark of God, and the throne of the divine presence of God. So, regardless of rebellion, God always finds a way to save man. Now let's look at the first scripture here. Genesis in chapter 6. We want to read a few verses from verse 5. There may be around verse 13. It says, "And God saw the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him to his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast and creeping thing and the fowls of the air. For it repented me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord." Is that great? Noah found grace. They always, as they say, have a ram in the ticket. And when God look at man and he see their condition, It said it grieved them to his heart. These are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man and perfect in his generation. And Noah walked with God. Isn't it good to walk with God? We are saints supposed to walk with God and talk with God. That was the purpose that God created man in the first place. Adam and walked and talked with God, and they had fellowship. And God's goal is to have fellowship with him. And Noah walked with God. And Noah begot three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japhet. The earth was also corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with violence. Now you compare the world back then and the world today. Man has strayed from God. Corruption and violence is upon the earth. But God is still extending his love. Back then was the ark, now we have the church, where the saints of God could fellowship and even walk and talk with God in union and communion. Now, God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupted, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. Make thee an ark of gopher wood. Room shalt thou make in the ark, and shalt pitch it. And this is the fashion thereof. God gave Noah the dimension. He gave him all the instructions, and Noah was obedient to God's command. Let's read some more. The height of it was given, cubic height. Then a window was put in the ark in cubic heights to finish it off. They had doors in the ark and was three stories high. And behold, I do bring a flood of water upon the earth to destroy all flesh, when is the breath of life from under heaven, and everything that is in the earth shall die. Now, it's not an easy thing that God had to do. But because of rebellion, because of violence, because of the type of behavior, God had was to take action. And sometimes even our kids, we don't want to punish them, but eventually we will have to do something because of their rebellion. Now let's look at the very first point here. First, God's observation of the sinful state of man. When we look even in the world, we see the sinful state of man today. God looked at man, and they multiplied on the face of the earth, and he saw wickedness was great, and every imagination of the thoughts of the heart was continually evil. Could you compare today and yesterday? And as a result, the Lord said, I will destroy man that I have created off the face, both man and beast and creeping thing and the fowl of the air, for it repented me that I have made them. So God made a decision that the way the earth was going, he had was to make a change. But isn't that good? But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Thank be to God that regardless how wicked the world may come, there are people, God's people, who have found grace in his eyes. Now, there's a misconception between God's people and the human race. Now, there's only one race, the human race. But you must realize that which is born of flesh is flesh. And the natural birth is to be on the earth. But the spiritual birth is to be with God in heaven. It's two types of birth. That which is born of flesh is flesh. So, folks say we are all God's children. We are not all God's children. Even Jesus said you have the father, the devil. To be a child of God, you must be born again through Jesus Christ our Lord. So although God created us in his image and his likeness, he loves us with everlasting love. He cares for us. That's why he extends his love towards us. That's why he sent his son, his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. So the ark is a place where you could have gone to for safety, but men rejected it. Now let's look at the scripture. I looked up the word wicked. It means morally bad, depraved, mischievous, or playfully malicious, obnoxious, and offensive. That's what God saw. He saw men getting worse. Now let's look at a scripture here in Romans chapter 1. I read a few verses here. Verses 28 to 32. It says that, and as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient, being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit, malignity, whisperers, backbiters, haters of God, despiteful, proud boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, without understanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, implacable and merciful, who knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them also. Even if you hang out with the wrong crowd, God is holding you accountable. So this is the type of thing what God saw. He saw that men didn't retain the knowledge of God. They had no fear for God, and they went about doing the old thing. And we're living in a state today that men have returned to the same lifestyle with no respect for God. So God is not pleased with that. Let's look at the next scripture here in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 1 to 7. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 1 to 7. Let's see what it says here. This know also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parent, unthankful and holy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, of lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying the power thereof. From such turn away. So this is the attitude of the world today. That's why we need to return back to our Bible study. That's why we need you dads out there to take back your home. What's going on? Drugs, alcohol, and all sorts of things. At least when I was growing up, my parents took handle of things. Make sure I pray. Make sure I do what is right. Keep you out of prison. Keep you up those kind of negative influence. But the world is drawing the kids. So we need prayer and we need grace and we need strength to pray for our family and take back our family. The enemy is enraged against our family. No, he wants to change the structure of our family. So we have to be real prayed up. We're not wrestling against flesh and blood, no. But it's against principalities now. It's against powers, against the rulers of darkness, against wickedness in high place. So you folks got to wake up. Wake up. For your redemption, draw it nigh. The day is at hand. And God was displeased with the folks in Noah's day. And you know what I watch? Even clean animals get into the ark. When Noah was building the ark, they probably called a foolish old man. As a matter of fact, he didn't build the ark near the beach. He built it on a mountain. So it never rained before. So people misunderstood that it would rain. They never believe. And we as believers want to show them. They say Noah preached 120 years. That was about the time he took to build the ark, because he didn't have no electricity and special tools. And they made fun. And if you notice, God gave Noah the command. He preached to the folks. He warned them about the rain one day. They never take heed. But all of a sudden, it rained. And the ark was secured. But Noah, while he was building the ark, they was making fun and laughing at him. And they noticed it's Noah and his three sons and their wives and his wife. Build the ark. No help. And even folks in the church today is no help. Now they like the fancy stuff. Come and dance and praise and worship. Never attend Bible study. But Sunday morning, 6-inch spikes. Come to have a good time. But we ought to study God's word. We got to prepare ourselves to meet our master. If you can't worship God on the earth, what makes you think you're worshiping in heaven? So you got to wise up. Take the note from Noah. Noah built an ark of safety. No one got in there. No one, no other man, no other family but Noah and his family and his sons' wives. When I was studying this, I said, imagine the clean animals went in, but nor the human, nor the family. Harden not your heart, saints. Folks, don't harden your heart. Too late shall be the cry. This is about the family. You want to seek your family. What's going on in the world? Look at violence and corruption. Look at our young people dying every day. You want to bring your kids around the table and see God and pray for them. You love your family. And everything is centered around the family. Baby dedication is around the family. Marriage is around the family. Even funerals are around the family. So everything is centered. God know our family is a central part of life. So think on these things. Now I want to take a short break, and we'll be back shortly. God bless you.